Now, Bolton is famous for a few things. It's famous for its textile industry. It's famous for its football team. It's famous for Fred Dibner. It's also famous as being the home or birthplace of Amir Khan the boxer. But there is a motorcycle manufacturer here who are punching above their weight. Welcome to Jubilee Works, the home of CCM motorcycles. I've come here to find out how a small northern company, known for its scramblers and military bikes, has reinvented itself with one of the hippest motorcycles in town. CCM, or Clues Competition Machines, was the brainchild of Alan Clues, a champion trials and scrambles rider in the 1960s. He was a great fan of BSA works bikes, so as his son Austin tells me, when BSA went out of business, Alan Clues pounced.
He bought 500 tons of parts, which, you know, more or less serviced about 10 years of production.
Over the next two decades, CCM made a name for itself with its race-winning scramblers and trials bikes. In 1976, Eddie Kidd, Britain's answer to Evel Knievel, broke a record for the world's longest jump on a CCM bike.
His father and one of his friends were stood at the end of the run when he landed with a blanket to slow him down. And the bike went into the blanket, and I think it drew his father into the bike, who broke both his legs.
You successfully do the jump,
but then there was some drama afterwards.
In the 1990s, CCM brought out the much bigger 450 dual sport bike. But when their supplier BMW stopped making the 450 engine, they had to think fast about what to do next. And that's when they came up with this, the CCM Spitfire, a radical new bike which made the biking world sit up and beg. It's got a Husqvarna engine, a hand-welded frame, a six-speed gearbox, and more attitude than a Donald Trump comb-over. And as manager John Drogan tells me, it all started on the shop floor.
It is pretty much an exact rendition of the sketch that was created. Literally over in that corner, a few guys, all these enthusiasts here talking about, if they're not talking about football or women or whatever, it's motorbikes.
Yeah.
Chris, chief designer, was just sat there and he started sketching, you know, back of a fag packet job.
Yeah.
A little idea of the guy's thoughts and dreams and so on. Thought there's something in this. Took it to Austin and he said, let's stick it on the CAD machine. And created this thing that became known as the Spitfire.
The limited edition Spitfire debuted at the London Bike Show in 2017 and was an instant online sensation.
We had tens of thousands of hits. It just got shared all over the world. Within 7 days, all 150 of these beautiful bikes went.
It was an amazing moment, but like every silver line cloud, there was darkness on the outside.
We'd sold to these customers on the basis that they would have this plaque right here that says, for example, this one here,
12.
Number 12 of 150.
Yeah.
You know, this one's been handed over to the customer this week. Number 12 of 150. And, you know, I don't want to see somebody else with number 155 or number 253 or whatever.
No, right.
I want to be one of 150 and that's it. And I think we would have had a bit of a mutiny on our hands. So we thought, okay, right, let's put that to one side. We've made a great bike. Where can we take this?
And the answer was creating limited editions of a Spitfire scrambler, a calf racer, a flat tracker, and coming soon, a Spitfire bobber.
As the boss, what's the future, do you think, of the British motorcycle industry?
I think it's very healthy. We've gathered together 800 orders now for our Spitfire. So it's never been a better time for us. We're hoping to move into a new factory late 2019 and be producing, you know, a couple, 2,000 or 3,000 bikes a year for UK market and export.
So what a fantastic British success story. But is the Spitfire just about style, or is there any more? I'll test ride it later in the show. But first, the latest in bike fashions. One great British company to another, I've been at CCM, looking at their fabulous new bike, the Spitfire. The only question is, does its performance match its looks? As always, there's only one way to find out. Straight away with this bike, you feel it's straining at the leash. You might not want to ride all the way to Monaco on it, but zipping around the back streets of Bolton, it feels like a perfect urban scrambler. Once you get out into the country and you can open it up a little, it gets even better. The Husqvarna engine sounds great. The wide handlebars make the riding position really comfortable, and the whole package feels fast and very responsive.
When you first get on a motorcycle, for me anyway, because I ride so many different ones, you know whether you're going to get on with it or not. I think the best way to describe it is that I think I could have an affair with this motorcycle, but that could turn into a long-term relationship. Why? Because suddenly you feel at home on the bike. The heritage of CCM with its enduro bikes and off-roading has been translated into this frame and into this choice of engine. So you feel as though that you are on a kind of enduro motorcycle, but you're actually on a really cool street sled. Because what you've got is you've got a hooligan engine in a hooligan frame, but at the same time, it exudes quality in something that looks, because it looks like a custom build, that it wouldn't be that. Okay, those are the good things. Couple of foibles. First thing is, hang on, to start the machine, you don't have a key, you just put this on there, right? So that's great, and then you press the button and you're away. But I would get off this bike, and then I'd come back 2 hours later, and I'm pretty sure the battery would be flat. Because you've got to do this to switch it off. There you are. The other thing is this. Can I draw your attention to the side stand? You can't actually put this side stand down, right? There it flicks up, right? You can't put it down when you're actually on the bike. So you've got to get off and do this. But, you know, you can live with it. And like all these foibles of motorcycles, you'll get on with it fine. But hey, look, man, first impressions, blimey O'Reilly. And I'll tell you the best thing, man, it's British.
I don't just want to fly the flag, though. The joy of this bike definitely is as much to do with how it performs as how it looks. It feels great going into corners, whether you've got your knee down or you're opposite locking it enduro style. Either way, it's solid and confident.
I've just let it stretch its legs just a little bit. And I've got to tell you, man, this thing is hilarious. You know, I haven't got up into sixth gear yet, but I'm on my little mini TT circuit here up on the moors. And this thing just delivers the grin factor. I've talked to you about the foibles of it. There's no front mudguard on this one, so I've got a few bits of gravel and stuff in my face. Who cares, man? This motorcycle is, to me, amazing. It was a massive risk for this to come into production. Thank God CCM have done it, because I tell you what, man, this is a lovely thing.
Coming up, we put the finishing touches on the Harley.
They're lovely. Putting them on, though, is something that absolutely terrifies me.
And reunite the Wild Bunch.